Good afternoon, YouTube. What's going on? It's Mesa back at it with some Destiny 2. In this video, we're going to talk all about the Destiny 2 beta, which we know we're going to get the reveal of in terms of the date on Monday night or Tuesday. Well, Monday night is the Sony press conference. Keep it locked in here. Make sure you subscribe. I'll be covering and uploading stuff Monday night as information comes out. Now, I've seen a lot of chatter on Twitter, on social media that, hey, the Destiny 2 beta is going to be what we saw at the D2 reveal that I got to play. And that's the one story mission, it was a strike, and then also the one PvP game mode. Highly doubt that, guys. There's no way they could just limit it to that. They got to kind of do what they did with the Destiny Beta 1. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. But let's talk about what we want in the beta and what they need to put in the beta. What's going to be the most important things that is going to make this a successful beta? Remember, guys, I mentioned this the other day from the Go Forward, from my Destiny 2 videos, when it comes to the beta, when it comes to guides or anything like that, I'm going to be keeping in mind that there's going to be people who never played Destiny, especially since they're marketing it to a new audience, and that's going to be the PC folks. So let's take a look at it from a business perspective, okay? Why have a Destiny 2 beta? What's the point? What's the purpose of it? Well, first off, there's a brand new audience, which is going to be the PC audience, okay? More than likely. A lot of the folks on PC probably never played Destiny ever before. They've played other shooters or something like that. I'm of course, generalizing here. And the other goal is going to be to get folks that are into Destiny 1 back into Destiny 2. Think about it. There are a lot of people who did tap out after year 1. It's safe to say maybe the initial rollout of Destiny with the story and how basically the beta we had for Destiny 1, most of the content in the game, the vanilla Destiny, was in the beta. So they've got a fine line. They need to rope new people in. They need to keep us who are into Destiny, obviously hyped and excited for Destiny 2. And then they got to bring back folks who maybe tapped out after year 1 or 2. Now, I'm probably going to come out with a video in the next week or so with basically what is Destiny. And that's going to be geared totally towards people who never played the franchise before and also geared towards the PC folks. So my core audience, you guys will probably yell at me or laugh at me at this one. But hey, guys, they've mentioned numerous times, whether it's Activision, whether it's Bungie, they want to appeal to a new audience. So now the Destiny 1 beta, let's think about that for a second. So what did we get? We got some PvP, got a couple of maps, we got one strike, and we got some story, and we also got some patrol, but we also got to patrol the entire Cosmodrome, which I think was a little bit too much. And then also I remember that one Saturday night they opened up the moon for 2 hours to play the Dark Beyond story mission, and we could go explore around. Now I'm gonna go and generalize here again because I'm the master of generalizations, but the vibe I got from the D2 reveal was that Destiny 2 is gonna be very PvE heavy, but then at the same time for the PvP competitive multiplayer people, cater to them as well. But overall, in terms of content, the gist that I got was that it's going to be very PvE heavy. They need to hook new people in that this is a looter shooter, and it's a grinding game that wants you to come back over and over. Now, what's going to make us come back over and over? So first off, I think they need to give us, obviously, patrols. Remember, one of the big things that's going to be new to Destiny 2 is the open world exploration. That's something I've been dying for since I initially played Destiny, is hey, you've got these beautiful destinations, and lots of real estate, not enough stuff to do. So we know that when it comes to open world exploration, they're adding a lot more. They're adding adventures. They're adding things that we have to go and find. I forget, is it called Lost Sectors or Dead Sectors? I forget. But basically things that remind me of remind me of the cauldrons from Horizon Zero Dawn. They really need to push that, but at the same time, all right, we got a couple of destinations. One of them, the main one, is going to be the European Dead Zone. Now, they've touted that numerous times, that that's going to be the biggest destination I think they've ever created. If they give us that entire destination to explore, I don't think that's going to work. What they should do, in my opinion, remember, we're going through everything here. For the destination, they need to give us patrols. They need to give us a part. What I'm going to recommend, or at this point, I can't recommend anything, but what I'm hoping they do is either give us one of the destinations, but maybe quarantine some of it off. Don't give us everything to explore. Maybe give us one adventure, maybe 1 to 2 story missions, and one strike. Because if we think about Destiny 1 right now, in terms of PvE, it's basically lumped off of, okay, you could do strikes, you could do the weekly story playlist, you could go do the raid if you like. So they really need to add and emphasize this new content, which is basically adventures, the new patrols, new public events. They said they're revamping everything, and to me, that's going to be a big selling point in this beta to not only rope in new people, but also us fanatics who are just diehard Destiny fans. Well, what's new in Patrol? I mean, I've always loved patrolling around and doing the patrols, but they do get kind of repetitive. It's the same thing over and over. If they're revamping all of the open world stuff, they need to showcase a lot of that in the beta, but not too much. Okay, they can't give away the whole thing. So my recommendation, or what I'm hoping on, is going to be European Dead Zone. More than likely, we're going to see the farm, which is the new social space. And I know a lot of people are saying we don't want to see it, but if you think about the Destiny 1 beta, all right, we had a character level cap. They'll probably do the same thing. And we had the tower, right? We were able to go to the tower, store stuff, go see the NPCs. We do need to see some of the NPCs. Now, what I'm gathering from Destiny 2 is everything is spread out. We know Ikora is somewhere, Zavala is somewhere, and Cade 6 is somewhere. So NPCs are going to be spread out. So what I'm hoping on is that we're going to get one major destination that we could free roam and patrol around. It probably would be the European Dead Zone. I hope they quarantine it off so that we can't just roam around the entire thing and explore everything. And then when we get the game, we're going to be like, all right, I know the entire European Dead Zone. This is boring to me. No, they need to quarantine it off. Also, just give us the farm, which would be that social space, so we get the feeling of how things are going to work, how the vault system is going to work, where we're going to decrypt things. Who did Raul make it out alive? Is he alive? Is he going to be decrypting things for us? Remember, they did tease that. I think it was Mark Noseworthy or Steve Cotton. One of them in an interview said that we'll go to the farm or we'll go to social space to decrypt things. So Engrams are definitely coming back. Even though in all the PvE stuff that I played when I played Destiny 2, that's redundant, is that we didn't see any Engrams drop whatsoever. But pretty sure Engrams will be coming back, which you decrypt and hopefully get some loot from. But I don't want to see any exotics. Maybe a legendary or two, but for the most part, I don't want to see exotics. Maybe I don't even want to see legendaries. In the Destiny 1 beta, I don't think we saw any legendaries. Did we? No, it was all greens and blues the whole time. Now, from a strike perspective, more than likely just going to get the inverted spire strike, which I have up on my channel if you want to go watch the full thing in its entirety. And as for story, you know, when we played the Destiny 1 beta, we basically saw the entire first whole section of the story, which I don't necessarily want to see. I just want to see enough to get us out of, you know what? Maybe we could play the story that we saw in the D2 reveal, and not the story that's before that. I'm pretty sure that there is a story before that. And just get us right into the mix of the game, where we can go to the first social space, the farm, and start exploring around. I'm going to say this over and over. The exploration and the open world stuff is really going to be the selling point of this beta, in my opinion. You, of course, let me know in the comment section. Now, one thing I think would be totally killer if they included in this beta is quests. Maybe one or two quests. Now, I don't want an exotic quest, obviously, but I don't know. They did throw exotics at us. Well, we had exotics to play with when we went to the D2 reveal. But I want to see how the quest system works. I think also that will help in roping people in. The questification of Destiny 1 when The Taken King came out really was a game changer. It made it way more interesting than just doing the same things, doing bounties, doing patrols, the same old patrols, and then expecting things to drop. But doing a quest with multiple things to get done and to get some sort of reward was a big game changer in Destiny 1. So I hope we get at least one or two, some sort of, I want to say exotic quest, but just some sort of quest that we could just fiddle around with and see how it works within Destiny 2. Now for PvP, not much to talk about. I don't really have too many opinions on it, other than I hope we get one to two game modes and we get one to two maps tops, all right? Keep it simple. Just let us all get used to the gunplay. Let us get used to those maps real quickly. Remember I said it before, PvP felt way more gunplay heavy than ability spam. And remember, PvP is going to fours, no more sixes anymore. Although I hope that maybe once a week or they have a rotating playlist that does have sixes for people that just prefer it. But lately playing Iron Banner and playing a lot more skirmish with my friends, I've been enjoying threes more than I have sixes. Sixes and the ability spam right now, it gets so exhausting at times. So I think fours and moving to more gunplay, and they said this before, I'm pretty sure it was Josh Hamrick might have said it, that the time to kill is increasing when you play PvP. So that means more gunplay, less ability spam. You might get one to two supers per, if you're a real beast, you'll probably get two supers per game. If you're average like me, you might get one super, or at least I got one super during the PvP game I played. But it was me and Datto versus Luminosity, and safe to say, Luminosity cleaned our clocks pretty good. So that's going to do it for the video, guys. I want to hear from you guys in the comment section. What do you guys want to see in the beta, and what do you not want to see? Do you agree with some of the things that I talked about of what I want to see? Babble Mode's been engaged, and you know the usual, hashtag made it to the end. And that's it, guys. So keep it locked in here. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber. And Monday night, we get to find out what the date is. I'm still saying I think it's going to be July 17th. And that's pretty much it. So do me a favor, drop a like in this video, only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter at Mesa Sean. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube. And that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.